So let's get started with this lecture on actions on a linked list. We discussed what a linked list looks like, but we need to do the actions that we did on an array on the linked list. So let's just get started with this. So the first thing is, what do we know right now? We know that a linked list looks somewhat like an array, but it solves the problem that if the array is a contiguous block of memory, then how do we allocate more space to it so that it can store more stuff. So if there is something ahead of it, we cannot store something there because we cannot extend the array anymore. So we need a better solution. What do we need? We need a linked list. So a linked list is actually a number with something storing where the next number is stored based on the addresses. And if you are unsure about this, go watch the previous video in the same playlist. So we go ahead and add something known as a pointer, which points to the very next address where the next number or the data is stored. So it just points to that memory address and we can go ahead and find it. That is known as a linked list. But how do we know that the linked list has ended? Well, there's a special thing known as a null pointer. A null pointer points in no direction. There is no address at that location. It is the zero. It is the location where nothing exists. And it points to nothing. And it is known by everyone. Alright? And the first node is known as the head. Alright? So the first node is known as the head and it is pointed by a special variable known as the head. So the special variable known as head is actually pointing to it. So it is a node star kind of variable that points to the very first node. And the last node, which points to null, is actually known as the tail node. And the tail actually points to this node. That is the concept of head node, tail node, and null node in the linked list. So let's just go ahead and see, how do we add stuff to the tail node? So adding stuff in the end, why are we talking about it? Well, it is the easiest to do. Adding stuff in the end is very easy to do. And the reason is, well, let's just say there was this guy who came in and wanted to join this linked list. Now this unsuspecting linked list actually wanted to make this guy join. So this responsibility of adding stuff at the end was given to the tail guy. But tail guy is pointing to something that is null. Now if this guy is added to the end, he has to point to null. Now the null guy is very famous. It is known as capital NULL in the C++ lingo. So there actually exists something known as null. So anybody can actually copy it. So the new node actually points to null, and the tail guy changes his pointer so that he can actually point to this new guy, and the tail changes. So this is how you add stuff to the end. You know the tail, you just add the new node there, and that is all. Oh, you need to change the tail. That is really important. Now once you know this, let's say you wanted to add stuff at random place. Now it sounds easy, but it is a little bit difficult, but we'll make it easy for you. So what we want to do here is, let's say we wanted to add this new node at the place that the second node is. So we want to add it just after the second node. So this guy wants to enter here, and so he copies this pointer because now he has to point to this third guy. That is the way this works. So the second guy was pointing to the third guy, and now this new third guy has to point to the previous third guy, which will now become the fourth guy. So they copy their pointers. And now the new node is actually pointing to its next. Well, the only thing left now is to make the previous node point to our new node. And that is easily done.